Hello everyone, welcome again to my channel. Today I will do the unboxing of the Dodgy N30. This comes with 4 GB of RAM and 128 GB of ROM. It has the MediaTek 6762 octa-core processor. It comes with a 6.5-inch HD Plus screen. It has a 16 megapixel rear camera, an 8 megapixel camera, 2 megapixel camera for the macro, and another 2 megapixel for portrait camera. The 8 megapixel camera is for the ultra wide angle lens. Okay, let's see what's inside the box. Of course, we have the phone, the charger. It comes with a 2-ampere 10-watt charger. It has USB-C charging cable. In the booklet we have SIM card needle, warranty card, user manual, a clear silicone case, and a thank you note. Okay, here we have the phone. Let's take out the plastic. As you can see, it's already pre-applied screen protector. Which looks very nice. It's nice quality. Only I think it's very sensitive for fingerprints. Okay, on the right side we have the power button, volume buttons. On top we have the headphone jack. On the side we have the SIM card slot. On the back side we have the camera. Fingerprint scanner. And on the bottom we have the USB-C charging port. Speaker and microphone. Okay. I'm going to set up my account and then I will come back to you. Okay, I set up my account. So let's start with the fingerprint scanner. As you can see, fingerprint scanner works well. It's pretty fast actually. Okay, About the apps, there are also not much extra apps on the phone, so no bloatware at all, which is good, of course, when it's stock Android 10. Phone also is running pretty smooth. Okay, let's go to settings. Now, the settings is also pretty standard. Used to stock Android. Network and internet, connect devices, apps notification, battery, display, sound, storage, privacy, location. As you can see, it's pretty standard. You can also choose for the three buttons on the bottom or gesture navigation. I'm trying now gesture navigation, and if you're used to it, it's pretty nice to work with it actually. Now, as you can see, it comes with stock Android 10. Security patch September 5, 2020. Google Play System update January. Okay, let's do some extra specs. Let's go to system. As you can see, it's the MediaTek 6762, 4 GB of RAM, and the internal storage that is free after the system is 106 GB, which is quite nice actually, especially in the price range of this phone. CPU, MediaTek Helio P22, 8x1500 MHz. It has a 720x1600 screen resolution, 6.5 inches, 270 dots per inch. Comes with a PowerVR Rogi GE 8320. Let's do some gaming. I use my Subway Surfer again. As you can hear, the speaker is also very loud. Quality is not the best, but it's very good. It's very loud actually. Game also is running smooth. I don't feel any lags. Okay, let's go to the camera. The camera looks pretty nice. We have the macro, we have wide angle, and then picture modes. We have panorama, we have video, beauty, standard picture, bokeh, pro, and mono. Now we go back to picture mode, go to settings, maximum picture size 16 megapixel. If we go to video, maximum video quality is full HD. zie ik de selfie camera. Video, it has maximum video quality is HD. Maximum picture quality is 8 megapixel. Yeah, for the rest it's standard options. Okay, I would say let's go outside to make some pictures and some videos. Conclusion about this phone, it's actually a very good phone, especially in this price range. Programs are running fast, smooth. The game I checked was also good. Speaker is also loud. It's not the best quality, but it's loud and it's good enough to listen to music or watching a movie or whatever. Quality of the phone itself is also very strong. Nice display. Camera is also good. I would really recommend this phone. And not only for daily use, not only for standard programs. But this phone is capable of doing a lot of things. I think you can easily use it as a daily driver. Okay, if you like this video, please like and subscribe. If you have any questions about the phone, ask me and I try to answer them. And I see you again in one of my next videos. Okay, thank you for watching. Bye bye.